have the four different lane references from the stock camera. In the middle, I have the same references associated with the center lane, I believe. And then the bottom is the requested torque or steering torque from OpenPilot. Unmodified is the thrust extent, and then the green is the part that is actually passed through, and what you see at the red is has been trimmed off. So. Basically, during a lane change, just overcome the OP torque. The stock camera recalculates its lane positioning. Chop off a whole bunch of the over torque requests from OpenPilot. Interesting thing is that the Bosch camera continues reporting lane positioning way down below the point where Honda allows it to do anything. I actually was on the brakes. I am still reporting lane positioning, so I think that I can continue having the Bosch camera steer the car even after hitting the brakes. Turn lane there, the left turn lane. This would all be torque would be pushing me or pulling me into the turn. So I'm glad it doesn't do that. So normally I would be having to grab the steering wheel about maybe one every third turn lane because it would be pulling me in there, but I'm able to filter it out so that all these red spaces are really beneficial. Also nice not to have to fight maximum torque just to change lanes. sure, but I guess maybe that one would have also. Both of those would have required me to grab the steering wheel. It's nice to be able to hit the gas to abort the car like that without cutting off the system. This one I wanted to hit. It would have fought me.